Not only that, idolatry, if you think about it, is the root of every social ill. We're talking about the social ills, the spiraling out of control. Behind every social ill, you'll find idol worship. You'll find idolatry. Let me give you a couple examples. All the sexual social ills, so pornography and exploitation and sexual deviance and all that kind of stuff, those people are worshiping Eros instead of the one true God. Eros or Aphrodite, she was the goddess of sexuality and lust and desire. Greed, which leads to the oppression of the poor, those people are worshiping Pultus, the idol of greed and wealth. The abuse of power, there's a lot of abuse of power in our culture, isn't there? Well, people who are worshiping power are worshiping Kratos, the god of strength and power. They don't know his name. They're just drawn to power. They have to have power. And once they get it, they abuse people to keep it. It's idolatry. Addiction. Dionysus was the god of wine and pleasure. And when we go to substances to meet our needs, to cope with our struggles, instead of running to Jesus to meet our needs, it's idolatry. Family neglect and materialism. Hermes is your god of choice, the god of commerce and travel. The lust for fame. Fema, P-H-E-M-A, is your god. This is the goddess of fame and gossip. I think it's fascinating that those two things go together. Fame and gossip. Watch TMZ lately. Abortion, euthanasia, gun violence. People that are doing these things are worshiping the god of Hades, that's actually his name, the god of the dead, the god of the underworld. Self-centeredness, that's a problem in our culture. That there actually isn't a Greek god for this, which I find kind of interesting. But we've created one, we call him or her me. And many of us, that's our idol, me. I am my own captain of my own ship. Just don't tell me what to do. It's idolatry. You've placed yourself on the throne instead of him. Once you start to see it for what it is, once you start to see the idolatry, once you start to see people worshiping these other gods, as you make yourself available to the Spirit, you will start to feel this great distress that he felt too. It'll come from the inside. Some of you say, I've never felt that. Here's your prayer. Jesus, let me see it. Let me feel it. Move from the inside so that I might speak of you. Jesus, let me see it. Jesus, let me feel it. Move from the inside that I might speak of you.